Alright guys, we're back, and this episode is probably going to be a little bit shorter, and probably a little bit more boring, because we just got a ton of stuff to go find. First, now that we have this new spell, I want to at least show off what it looks like. Use this spell to simulate a super form, doof! And this one takes away bow and ox, which is a little bit different. I think, actually so far, I think all of them have used bow. But whatever. So we're gonna close that off, and look at this dude. He's like this armor-wearing looking pig dude. He's kind of... Oh, look at that hair. Dude's like some 80s metal rocker. He looks pretty sick. I mentioned at the very end of last video that I kind of like this as my favorite transformation, because he's more like of a minotaur due to the ox-type form, and like combining it with wolf, which is obviously the whole point. But it's kind of freaking sweet. Again, he doesn't have any spells except for revert, but he's totally cool. So, I'm just gonna show him off for one little fight for some slimes. And he like freaking bull charges for epic damage. The dude is awesome. It's not his best form, but it's by far my favorite form that he has, and thus I will probably use that as my fourth character, aka this will most likely end up being my official final party of these four guys. Even though it's not his best form, I just like it the most. And that's where we stand, so... Anyway, immediately after getting this, however, unfortunately, they want to play a trick on me and give you the fourth form. You need the third form to get the fourth form, and so now I can go get it immediately. So in theory, you don't ever even have to freaking use this guy in a fight before you get his better one, which is just really dumb. But alas, that's the way it works. It's somewhere, I don't remember exactly where it is in this town. It's somewhere, let's be this, somewhere in here. Remember all that crap throughout the game so far that we've seen? Where it's like, you need to, okay, so it's not in here, that sucked. Where it's like, someone stronger needs to move this. Well, this is someone stronger. This dude is a beast. This dude is a truck. Where the hell is it? It's somewhere in this town. I gotta move something. I don't know where. Not here. What the hell? How do I get lost so freaking often? Like, I know where to go, but I don't know where to go. You know? It's like the same reason people need GPS and crap. Like, you know where to go, and you just don't know how to get that last few directional changes. I think I pushed this up and I pushed this to the side. Aw, crap! That wasn't it. Alright, let's try that again. Like, you always know how to get out of your own place, but you know, it's... more of an issue of, okay, seriously, guess who's stupid. There we go. Like the last few turns in someone's subdivision and crap, like that's where you don't know what to do. So, whatever, push those out of the way. What the crap? That wasn't exactly what I wanted. How do I get in here? That's where I want to get. I want to get in there. I didn't even know there was a treasure here. Oh, there we go. You see that up there? There, I just saw it. There we go. There we go. Move these big heavy blocks. And then we got a revert form out of this dude. Because I gotta talk to him as normal Karn. Oh, hey, one too much. Let me teach you the spell! And this is Karn's fourth and final transformation form fusion thing. So he has now completed his DBZ fusions. And this one... it's disgustingly broken and powerful, and I really, really hate it. It's just, it's ugly, it's stupid, it looks like a Muppet. So I don't like it at all, but, you know, whatever. Well, I'll have to use it at some point because he has it out of battle use as well, so we'll go with it from there. And then now back to finding, oops. No. There we go. Now I got to go, where do I want it to try Tantar? Got to go back to my digging. I think there's only one other place, no. Yeah, I think there's only one other place at the moment that I can dig to. I think there's four in the game, and so far we've seen two of them. I think, if I'm wrong, somebody needs to correct me. I meant to take notes of like, oh, this is here, and oh, this is there, but I never actually did while I was playing the game. As far as like where stuff is that I needed to move and crap like that, which I really, really should have. It would have made things so much easier. Because then I would be going exactly where I needed to go, at least, as opposed to kind of wandering around a little bit. But so be it, here I am. It's somewhere around here. I don't know exactly where. Somewhere. I think it's up here. There we go. Hey, memory serves me right. I can't remember crap that I need to for school and work, but I can remember 20-year-old video games. Alright, so we find a bunch of loot in here, which is all it is, which is totally cool. You take an L potion. Love potion. I should give that to whatever. Take an A potion. A trap triggered a sprawling! Aw, crap. I opened it in the wrong way. Alright, so Magu completely recovered from opening that chest. I thought it would be on the left, but I guess it was on the right. This one's gonna kill him. Triggered a boom! And he dies. So, he's supposed to open that one, have him die, and then you cure him with the other one, but I did that wrong. Whatever. I've grabbed some, God, I hate that. Why are freaking... I guess each hand is a claw, so he can't hold the shield. He doesn't have any fingers. I guess that makes a little bit of sense, but... I have no idea what this clog is. But it just sounds like something that should go to Magu. I don't know. What's it even do? Raises magic and raises speed. I don't want to give it to you because you suck. Screw you, Magu. I wish I could name you, like, Diglett. That'd be awesome. Anyway, so you get out of here. And now we gotta warp somewhere else. Let us warp to... where is it? I think it's... oh! City of Gold. There we go. Aria. Excuse me. Just had some pizza. Warriors, our fate is in your hands. So is there something heavy to move in here? I don't think so. And if I miss something at this point, like, I'm going to be getting all the critical stuff, or all, like, the important, useful, significant items. So if I miss something that's minor, then I don't really care that much. It's not a very big deal, so... anyway, now we go into Puka, which just sounds... okay, Doof doesn't sound all that fantastic either, but... looks like it uses bow again. So I think all of these freaking use bow. This one uses Gobi and Ox as well, but... anyway, so we got Karn in here, and let's take a look at him. He's this floating green duck gremlin thing who just looks stupid as hell. But he can move these things. He just screeches. You guys hear that? That screech? Sounds like a... I don't know. Sounds like you're choking a cat and he's trying to scream at you. Take a dark bracelet. So whatever. We get a dark bracelet. And we're just going to equip it to him, because you're a thief, you dark... I don't know, whatever. And it raises his fate a ton. Raises his action, which he doesn't need a speed raise. Man, I don't want to give that to you, then that's really good. That's really good. I'll give that to someone else, I think. I'll work on equipment later, don't worry about equipment. And while we have Puka, let's... actually, no, first I need to go to one more place first. Warp back to Gust. And we need to get the hell out of here. If I can move my controls properly. And there was one more stone door out over here somewhere when we first got out of the water. And I think that's actually going to do it as far as our side quest stuff for the moment. I know there were other heavy objects to push, but I don't remember where they are. Oh, I totally wasn't supposed to skip that. But I don't remember where they are. I don't think there's anything critical. So, let's get in a fight first. Let's get in a fight first. There we go. So we can have Doof, or not Doof, so we can have Puka do some garbage. Whatever. Kind of looks like an alien out of, like, Contra or something. So he just, like, screeches at you like the Dragon Whelps from Breath of Fire 3. He's gonna hit most enemies for 999 points. Even when you go to, like, the hardest place in the game, he's still gonna be swinging for, like, 600-something. Just look at his HP. It's 750. It's ridiculous. He's obviously fast as hell. So, only 255. What the hell happened? I don't know. I thought he just hit the other guy for 999. Whatever. He's too good. And he's dumb. Like, he's... I don't know. Doof is totally cooler. Like, that's all I have to say. Doof is just flat out cooler. We get a love bracelet. And the love bracelet is the same or similar to the life armor, how somebody gains a hit point every step I take. So that one's going to go over to Nina, because I want my white mage to have more, you know, whatever. Skull ring, okay, skull ring adds defense. Dream, I don't think dream ring does anything. Actually, can you equip the clog? Alright, so raises your action and your magic. Yeah, we'll give that to you, that's cool. Clear clothing. Whoa, that's a huge defense boost. I do like how the angle armor counterattacks a spell, though. That's really, really cool. Crap, man. I'll leave the angle armor on for now. Although, if that's if that stands for clear clothes, that totally needs to go to one of these chicks. But, I think that's all the treasure for the moment. Or at least that I plan on... I just gotta think. I'll pause the video and think for a second, because I know there's other heavy boxes to move. I don't remember where they are, and there's nothing significant or critical with it. So I'm not sure with that. And I know there's something else that I need to get for a dragon form later on in the game. I could get it now, or I could get it later. I can't use it now if I get it now. But since we're only at 11 minutes, I'm probably just gonna get it now, I guess. But I'm gonna pause the video and think for a second on, where potential treasure crap might be, so hold on for just a sec. Alright, guys, so there's, as far as I could really tell, there's nothing worth going back for or trying too hard to move blocks for. Again, if somebody points it out, then I would be more than glad to go back and grab something if I've missed it. But at the point I'm at, I just don't really feel like trying too hard to go grab stuff, so I'm not going to. But I am going to go back for one little thing that I can't quite use yet, but I may as well just grab it now while it is a short video, and just so be it from there. So we gotta go back up here. Remember the first part of the game, or when we first got a fishing rod, I went around and I fished in like random places trying to find crap. I think I just went the wrong direction. I think I totally just went the wrong direction. I think so. I can't tell. And there were a few places where I fished, and it was like, you know, whatever, no big deal. I couldn't get anything at that time. Once we got Rod 5, I went back to most of them. But there's a couple fishing spots I didn't go back to, one of them being this place. And there's still something here. It's just not equipment or not anything that I need for the moment, so I've got to grab another wormy worm, grab some worm, and I gotta put me back in the front, and I should be able to get something here. There you go, I catch a slab. And let's just take a second to look at this thing. Where is it? Somewhere towards here down the bottom. Slab. It is written in an ancient language. Where the mystic water lies, the ultimate power sleeps. So, there's a little something to think about with that. A little bit of an RPG riddle going on. And, that's really as far as it is that we need to go. But, I guess I do still have some time. What am I gonna do? I'm gonna warp to Gust. I'm just gonna do like item crap and like get all my items organized. And you know, no, I'll do that later. Screw that. I'm going to first. God, I don't know what the hell I want to do. I'm gonna revert and I'm gonna go into Doof because Doof is a beast. Also, all of the forms that use bow, which is Shin, Doof, and Puka. No, not Puka. Not Puka. Shin and Doof can walk through forests, which is sweet because of bow, so that's really cool. So I'm still not going to lose that ability just yet anyway. And then, what's his face is dead. I don't care, but I'll go heal him up now, actually. Just because I can. I do wish to stay here. I did enjoy my stay. I probably won't come back, though. Okay, and now, going back to where I need to go, we'll just progress a smidge towards where we need to go. Not too much, just a smidge. Just so that I don't have to waste time progressing to the next place before I progress in the next episode is really all it's going to be, so that's fine. We'll probably end it around 20 minutes. And here we are. Oh yeah, also, at the last episode, or as soon, was it last episode? I think it was last episode, after we grabbed Magu, really quick, I was kind of just like digging around. Hush has been learned. I believe hush is silence. And I quickly went here and grabbed a root for a free treasure, which is actually significant. I kind of just did it out of force of habit and memory and didn't really mention it or pay any attention to it whatsoever, but that is actually something I believe that we need to get later, and in this way, just grabbing it immediately prevents you from having to worry about it, really, so. Look at that dude. That dude is just a beast. He doesn't even fit. His sprite doesn't fit in the square. That's how awesome it is. So Blue, with 300 AP, she's just gonna cast some ice, I guess. Maria's not gonna do much of anything. And then Doof for the mash. Boom. He's just such a beast, man. Dang, that guy's got some defense. That's alright, though. You don't have magic defense. You are dead. Well, did you see that? It didn't do damage to the guy in the middle. It just killed him. It didn't show a damage number. That was interesting. I wonder if there's something to that. If he's just, like, automatically dead from magic or something, and that's the reason for his super high physical defense. I don't know. But whatever. Dang! He crushed that dude. Dang, I critted at 42 points. A crit was 42 points, man. That's nuts. That dude's got some defense. I wonder if M Flea, if that stands for like Magic Flea or something. I don't know. Crazy. Level 30. Wow, I'm already level 31? Well, that's Blue. Blue is a little. Ice Axe. Holy crap. Holy crap. I'm learning like disgustingly epic spells at this point. Blue is just a beast, man. She is just a beast. I mean, Nina is probably, without really a question, my worst character, but she's the white mage, and you kind of have to have a white mage. In almost every RPG party, you need a white mage. You just do. I mean, consider it otherwise without having a white mage. Consider it being like a Nuzlocke without letting yourself use the Pokemon Center. You'd have to buy herbs and use herbs the whole game, or, you know, buy lemonades and fresh waters, but, you know, white mages are like the Pokemon Centers of video games. Anyway, so here's our next town. It's a little frozen over. It's called Spring, which is kind of funny because it's winter here. And something blah blah, something about a lake and a spire tower and a key. Let's talk to Einstein over here. There you go. Is buried. Only the mole people can uncover it. Well, a good thing I got me a mole person. So anyway, here's our town. I don't think there's anything of interest in here right now. I'm just going to check things out real quick, check out the houses. A tunnel, blah blah blah, leads to Scand. We've never had snow before! Well... well, you heard that correctly, but I've already taken care of them, so... yeah, I don't think there's anything of value in the town right now, but this is where I gotta be next, and this is where everything from the game is gonna progress from. He likes to climb towers. He likes to climb towers and doesn't afraid of anything. But since this is where we are, so yeah, I just wanted to not have to do this at the start of next episode is really all I wanted to do. Just kind of take this out as, oh, talk to the old lady. Spire controls the climate. I take an herb. I don't care about herbs. We were proud of our waterfall, and now it's frozen. That would be sweet if you actually had a frozen waterfall, and it was just this massive block of ice that was stuck in an image of looking like it was moving, but it's not. That would look so freaking cool. Or if a waterfall just suddenly got, like, shut off with a dam. Like, what would the ground look like behind the water? Like, I think that'd be really cool to see. Cooler than the actual waterfall itself. I've been to Niagara like 4 times and it's just dumb. But whatever. I guess it's okay. Anyway, guys, this is where we're going to end our episode. I'm going to save the game real quick. And that's going to do it for this. I know it was slightly more boring and slightly less productive this time. No killer references or anything like that. Well, no, I did just throw in RB and the Chief a minute ago. So, ha! I got one! I got it in there. But anyway, guys, thanks for watching. Take it easy. And next time, we're going to pick things right back up with Doof. Master Doof. Doof, 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 doof. He's a beast. Oh, I was going to rename people, and I forgot. Whatever. I'll probably never end up renaming the other people. Even though there are a few names that are chill. But at this point, I'm just never going to remember. And I'm never going to go back to Prima. Or at least not for a while. I suppose eventually I will. Yeah, eventually I'm going back to Prima. But not for a while. So, anyway, guys, thanks for watching. Take it easy. Take care. Peace.